Hello, and welcome to Annals Animated. Our video will take a look at Phosphodiesterase-5 Inhibitor Therapy for Pulmonary Hypertension in the U.S., actual versus recommended use. A paper by Dr. Deborah Kim and colleagues published in the June 2018 issue of the Annals of the American Thoracic Society. This study's main objective was to examine the prescribing patterns of phosphodiesterase-5, or PDE-5 inhibitor use in a nationwide sample of United States veterans with pulmonary hypertension who received care through the Veterans Health Administration. The study found that guideline-discordant and potentially inappropriate use of PDE-5 inhibitor was highly prevalent in U.S. veterans with pulmonary hypertension. The study investigators performed a retrospective cohort of all veterans with a diagnosis of pulmonary hypertension between 2005 through 2012. They used administrative and pharmacy databases to identify veterans with pulmonary hypertension, defined by an ICD-9 code for pulmonary hypertension. PDE-5 inhibitor use was defined as receipt of a prescription for daily PDE-5 inhibitor use. The primary outcome of the study was a number of veterans who may have received inappropriate PDE-5 inhibitor for pulmonary hypertension. The study investigators created and validated an ICD-9 code-based algorithm to categorize study participants into each of the five World Health Organization, or WHO, groups of pulmonary hypertension. PDE-5 inhibitor use for WHO Group 1 pulmonary arterial hypertension was considered appropriate. PDE-5 inhibitor use for WHO groups 2 or 3 pulmonary hypertension was considered potentially inappropriate, and use in WHO groups 4 and 5 pulmonary hypertension was considered of uncertain value. During the study period, a total of 108,177 veterans with pulmonary hypertension were identified, of whom 2,790, or 2.6%, were prescribed daily PDE-5 inhibitors. Of these, 19% were classified as having WHO Group 1 pulmonary hypertension, and therefore were receiving appropriate PDE-5 inhibitor treatment. 61% were classified as WHO Group 2 or 3 pulmonary hypertension, and were classified as receiving potentially inappropriate PDE-5 inhibitor treatment. And 13% were identified as WHO Group 4 or 5 pulmonary hypertension, and were classified as receiving PDE-5 inhibitor therapy of uncertain value. Secondary outcomes in a subset that underwent chart abstraction found that only 48% had undergone right heart catheterization, 32% had echocardiographic findings suggestive of pulmonary hypertension, and 20% had neither an echocardiogram nor a right heart catheterization. Additional findings included: 59% of the PDE-5 inhibitor prescriptions originated in the VA system and 40% in the private sector. 64% were prescribed a PDE-5 inhibitor by a cardiologist or pulmonologist. VA primary care providers prescribed PDE-5 inhibitor treatment in 24% of cases, but only after a clinician outside the VA had initiated the prescription. Limitations of the study include possible misclassification bias, since the investigators used an administrative database. In addition, these study results may not be generalizable to patients outside of the VA system. In conclusion, the investigators demonstrated a high rate of inappropriate PDE-5 inhibitor use for WHO Group 2 and 3 pulmonary hypertension, and a low rate of right heart catheterization in U.S. veterans being treated with PAH-targeted therapy. For additional details, please read the article by Dr. Kim and colleagues in the June 2018 edition of the White Journal. Thank you for watching Annals Animated.